Hello. In this instruction, I will introduce how to use the Trigino LoRaWAN Gateway LPSA to decode the LoRaWAN sensor such as LHT65, LDS01, LSN15 to decode the sensor value and then send to a TCP server. This TCP server can be run on a PC. You don't need to have internet connection. Of course, you can put this server in cloud. Here in the server, we will run a TCP socket, and the socket can receive the value from the LPSA directory, and then we can see the value directory without LoRaWAN server. First, in this case, this sensor has a need to config to ABP mode. We config the sensor first. Here is the sensor of LHT65. By default, this sensor is configured as OTAA sensor. In this application, we need to configure the sensor to ABP mode. We can see how to configure here. First, we need to run AT plus FDR. This will reset the sensor to factory default. And in this window, we can first configure it to ABP mode. AT. This will configure the sensor to ABP mode. Oh, sorry. We need to input the password first. Okay. So we use this command to configure the sensor to ABP mode. Is no need to join to the LoRaWAN server. It can, in this mode, it can work without LoRaWAN server. Here we notice that data sensor has the frequency band is AS923. In the gateway, we need to configure to the use the same frequency band. After configure the sensor to ABP mode, the second we config is to have a short uplink time. By this configuration, the sensor will uplink the message every 30 seconds. And then we run ATZ to reboot the sensor. Now we can see the sensor will transmit the data value every 30 seconds. Okay. The next step is we need to configure the LPSA to receive this sensor data and decode the sensor data. Because we don't have LoRaWAN server here, so we need to decode the sensor value in LPSA. Here is the configuration UI of the LPSA. We need to choose the frequency band. First, we need to confirm because the TCP transfer to the socket to the TCP server is the latest feature. So we need to make sure that our device has the firmware version of this one, which is built on December 9. It is very new version. And okay, first we need to configure the LPSA to accept the LoRa data from the sensor. So it need to configure to the same frequency band here, AS92A, this frequency band. So it can receive the data from the sensor. Second, we need to config the app decryption. In this, we need to enable app decryption, and because the sensor, we need to decode the value of sensor, so we need to input the keys from the sensor here. Here we need to input the device ADDR. We can get the keys from the sensor by ATCFG. Okay, so AT. By this command AT plus CFG, we can got the sensor keys. Here we can see the device address is this one. We need to input device address to device address and the APP S key to the APP session key and the network session key to the network session key here. You can see this is, we have already configured this sensor here. Here is what I have configured. There is decoder. The decoder tells how to decode the stream of this sensor, the value of this sensor. We will explain later. First, we need to we see how to get the data. Okay. So now we can see that the LPSA already be configured with the sensor. After we have enabled the APP decryption, we have got the sensor value, we should able to see the data on this directory. It's WAT IoT channels, and we can see here it's a file called, the file name is the same as the device address of the sensor. If we use hasdam, we can see the data of this value. This is what the sensor has sent to us. And the next step is how to forward this data to the TCP server. First, we need to create the TCP server in our PC. There is a very simple tool here, the socket tool. We use the socket tool to create the TCP server. We run the socket tool. Okay. Here, this one is our PC IP, and we have created a socket based on 60,000, and we start this socket tool. Okay. Already start. Okay, the socket to here. So, next step, we need to go to the LPSA to input the server address. Server address is our socket, our TCP server address, and the server port must be the same as the port we use in the TCP socket to, and save apply. After that, we can see this two window. Okay. Once the sensor start send the value, we can see the value arrive the socket tool. And this is the hash data of the value. And this is the device address of the value, and this is the data. Okay. You can see This data value is the same as what we have got in the hasdam. So actually, this equal to device address, and this equal to this part. This is ask to value, and this is actually is F, the same. How to explain this value? We can check the. In our wiki, we have the communication with APP. In our wiki, we have the communication with APP and node with download relevant server. And here has the decode method. The decode method describes how this value stands. So user can check here to see how it stands for. And okay, so now we have already finished the fast test of the decode the ABP node and send to the data to TCP server. User can modify the how the LPSA send the data to TCP server. We can see here the code. Here is the TCP process TCP script in the LPSA in the LoRaWAN gateway. This script describes how to send the data to LoRaWAN server to the TCP server. Sorry, and here we can see this. First, here this is a loop. This loop will keep running. Once the gateway receive a new LoRaWAN message, it will go to this loop, and then here is how to process send data. Now, because our decoder has choose the S2 code, so we will send the ISSI and the payload here. We will send the ISSI and the payload directly to the server here. We can see the TCP data. Finally, we use this. If we choose other decoder. The decoder is actually listed in here, etc loader decoder decoder. If we choose the decoder, decoder. For example, this is our LHT65. If we choose this decoder in the web UI, then and save with this decoder. The LPSA we use this decoder to decode the sensor value first and then send to the TCP network to the TCP server. Here is the command to send this data to the server. Okay, we can see there's many messages received on the server. And so now we can try to use the decoder. Actually, this decoder is writing in Lua, and user can also write this decoder in Linux bash script, and they put their decoder here in this directory. After they put that, they will be able to see the decoder here in this menu, and then choose the right decoder to decode the sensor data to the server. So now we try to change the decoder. First, we delete what we have created. And then we add this again. APP network session key is this one. Okay, we choose the decoder to use LHT65. Use this decoder and add. Now we don't have this one. We add. Okay, we see already add this new entry, and then we check this from the server. We see the next the next uplink, what we can see. Okay, next uplink is coming. Let's just see what it shows. Now we can see the value is different. Here is what we have got because we already put the decoder. Actually, the temperature and these two temperature is warm, but it doesn't matter of our collection because in my test units, these two sensor value has warm. So, but that doesn't affect. This is what we have got, the battery and the humidity this is warm data because the sensor is broken. And this is the temperature, and this is the SSI, and this is the SNR, and this all is based on the decoder we choose. We choose this decoder, and user actually can add their decoder and add to this directory there. For the LPSA, here there is some notice. In this firmware version, after we choose the TCP server as the connection, we see there is a red cross here, but it doesn't matter because the in next version, firmware version, we will fix this one, but this doesn't matter. User can check if the TCP is running by log grid F. So we can let's see what happened if there are sensor data arrive. Okay. This is not the sensor data arrive. This one from here. We can see the sensor data arrive. This is the sensor data. And this is the sensor original data, and we can see the server port config here. And decoder for this data, this channel, this sensor is choose to LHT65, and the TCP data is here. This the TCP data is what the gateway will forward to the TCP server. Okay. So that's all for the connection of the. To use the ABP to convert the ABP LoRaWAN sensor data value to a TCP server without the LoRaWAN server. Thanks for your listening. If you want to know more about the detail of this feature, you can check this URL in our wiki. Go to the wiki main page and here find the communication with ABP and LoRaWAN without LoRaWAN server. Thank you.